What we gonna do right here is go back. Way back. Back into time.
It's time to kick it old school with a new school flair. Taking you back to a time where things felt good.
Wow, I feel good.
Welcome to Old Fashioned Health. Today is the day to take back your health. Old Fashioned Health is just the right place to do it. Your host, Alvin, is determined to make sure you are in good health inside and out. Now, the time has come for some good Old Fashioned Health right here on 1100 AM. Here's
Alvin!
Okay! How y'all doing, Atlanta? How y'all doing? Old school, new school on the Old Fashioned Health Show. What's up, old school?
Man, what's going on, Alvin? What's going on, Atlanta? How you doing, brother?
Brother, I'm doing good. If I get any better, I don't know what I'm going to do with myself. I ain't going to be able to handle
it. Hey, man, but I want to talk about this weather, man, because I feel like this thing just came overnight. And
I
just
see you got on a sweater. That's how it is when you're from Florida, huh?
Man, I mean, I'm in the cool all day, every day, but when it just took me by surprise. Now, it's just like I'm trying to hide from the cold because I got to deal with it all day, every day, man, and I just hate it when it get cold.
You don't like cold weather?
I really don't. But I love the vibe of it, if that makes sense. Yeah. I love the vibe of the coldness, but I just hate going through it. You know what I'm saying?
So you're not used to the little chill.
Season changes. No, I'm not used to that. And I'm 3 years in the hole when it just comes to just being in Atlanta. So.
How did that hurricane Michael affect anybody you know in Florida? Do you know?
I honestly don't have people that stay in Panama City. I have been to Panama City and it's very beautiful. So just seeing how it is now, man, is just like breathtaking, yeah. You know, for me, yeah. Because it's just like I know how it is, you know, being from Florida and going through, you know, hurricane season and everything. And for them to say that it's up there with Katrina,
yeah,
is like, wow.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? So all, like, I know a buddy of mine that came in when I was at my other job. Buddy of mine came in, he had people that lived in Panama City, and good news that they had people that lived in Mississippi.
Okay.
You know, so they all evacuated the city. But for those who just didn't have no place to go, man, my condolences. And I really, really hope that, you know, they're safe, you know. So.
Yeah, it looks pretty bad down there. I was looking at the devastation. You know, old school, we take a lot of things for granted.
Yes, we do.
I mean, like, this week is beautiful, right?
Yes,
All we can have is a tornado or something, really, or something bad like that. And then it'll start looking as devastated as we see in Florida. And then Houston hadn't even, you got some places that just got over some storms last season, like Puerto Rico. Puerto Rico still have some places that don't have proper lighting, proper medical assistance that they need. They're dealing with a lot of diseases and stuff like that due to the bad weather and the water and all that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
And then you got Houston that's still struggling with the floods and stuff. And just imagine this, if you have in flooded areas that doesn't have have home insurance, doesn't have flood insurance.
Yeah.
And I can't imagine you good today and then all of a sudden you have a flood and your insurance policy does not cover it. And then you are in a disaster situation where now your house is not covered, but you've lost it and you still got a mortgage.
Right. Exactly. And you're still paying off something.
And you're still paying off something. Could you imagine that?
I cannot imagine just really giving up all my money, especially the time of need, really at the time of need, that I'm still giving away my money to a place that I really don't have no.
It's
no,
not yours
yeah, it's not really mine no more because it's all damaged.
It's all damaged.
I really can't imagine that. And I feel like for those who go through those types of things or even see those types of things should really, you know, be more. I think us as the people really need to be more appreciative of just what we have. And if we do see some tragic incident like that, we really need to invest a lot of money into those things and really not have those type of companies that will take stuff under the table and we won't see no results. So yeah, man, it's crazy.
It's kind of hard to imagine you've been in a home for 20 years and then all of a sudden a flood comes along.
Yep.
You have no flood insurance and you are like devastated.
Yeah, man. Yeah. But in Florida, I heard it's mandatory to have flood because we below sea level. So
but in some areas it's pretty obvious that they don't have to have insurance.
Yeah,
it's not mandatory in certain areas. So Yeah, so our prayers and thoughts go out to the people over in Panama City and the people that have already dealt with some disasters in the past. So we have had a lot of flood and rain. We've had fires in California. I'm telling you, man, we are all one situation from being in a bad situation. So we can't take life for granted as it is. And one other thing, just before we get started, we're going to talk about just mentioning the whole Kanye West thing. Every time I turn the television and the radio on, it's really, really bad. Everybody's talking about it.
Yeah.
But I want people to think about this. If the man has already said he know he has a mental situation going on, let's just start with that.
Me personally, Alvin, I'm pretty much over, you know, Kanye when it just comes down to this, man. It's just, it gets to the point with me, if you know, want to do your thing, just do your thing and, you know, move on. That's what side he want to be on. So,
well, it's not just the side of the political aspect that he's taking, but when he goes on these different rants and stuff.
Yeah, that's,
But think about it like this. If a person is mentally stable, don't have a problem, then they don't act like that.
Right.
So for me, I would have to give him, we would call it a pass, but you already know he has a mental problem. He has a situation.
Yeah.
So I hate the fact that those of us that know he has a problem, and then we, some of the news anchors and everybody is really, and a lot of other people kind of chiming in, saying a lot of things about him. But you got to keep in mind, this man still has kids.
Yeah.
And so later on, his kids are going to have to deal with I guess what people's thoughts are about their father, when you already know his father has a mental situation going on.
Right.
What I don't like is the president, knowing already, has seen this himself, putting it on display and thinking it's something cool. That's what I don't like. why would you take, you know, the man's not stable.
I mean,
why would you do that?
Look, man, the man hungry for attention. You know that by now.
Yeah,
you seen the 9/11 thing. He had the dang building on his head with two airplanes in his hands. Come on now, like, for real?
He did, wasn't it?
Oh, yeah, man. It gets deeper than that. Yeah, so I ain't going to talk about it. I'll show you. But, it's just one of those things, man. He's quote unquote, see my hand, celebrity type dude that likes attention, and he got a position of power and really don't know what to do with it right now.
Gotcha.
So,
okay.
I mean, hey, it happens. It's Hollywood. Okay. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah.
I mean, but you're a celebrity. You don't act like that.
I mean, look, it's certain levels of it. You know, you got different gatekeepers. Let's just say that. You got people.
We'll go with that.
Yeah, we got different people that's, you know, at the gate and, you know, allow certain things to come in and out at one point in time. It's levels to it.
Yeah.
So, yeah, man.
Hey, so listen, you all are listening to the Old Fashioned Health Show.
You know
what we always do? We start our show off with the Black National Anthem.
And why is that?
A lot of people don't know about it. We're trying to get our historically black colleges to start playing the Black National Anthem.
Come on, people, get hip to the game.
It is homecoming for my alma mater, which is Jackson State University.
Exactly.
I still don't know why a lot of these HBCUs are not playing the Black National Anthem. I just don't get it.
Exactly.
Especially, it's the Black National Anthem for your school. What's the problem?
Right, you know, right.
Maybe it's me.
Hey, man, I'm going to have to just go knock on the door over there and just be like, here, have it. It's
right.
It's free.
I bought it.
Yeah,
somebody needs to do it. It's like, come on, y'all. I know y'all know. But anyway. So we're going to talk about a couple of things, a couple of medical recalls I went over yesterday. But in case people don't know or forgot, you know, you need to take some of these things off your shelf.
Mm-hmm.
And then we're going to talk a little bit about a few other things that's going on in the news. But yeah, that's what we're going to do. And Old School got the best music in the house.
Come on, man. I try a little bit.
I want some good music today. It's Friday.
It's Friday, too.
Can you believe it? This week went by so fast.
Yeah, it went by quick, man. And guess what? It's only going to go by faster because this end of the year is approaching real quick,
will you,
man.
Tell me about it?
Real quick. But I just can't wait for Thanksgiving, man. I just want to chill with family.
You
just
get excited about Thanksgiving?
Yeah, I really am, man. It's been a long time.
I know, right?
Yeah.
All right, y'all. You all are listening to the Old Fashioned Health Show, Good Health Inside and Out, Old School, New School.
Yes,
here
soon.
On the Real 1100.
To ring. unexpected reason. Long as a rolling sea.
Get
free. From me to you, my sister, let freedom ring.
And from me to you, my sister,
let freedom ring.
From me to you, my brother.
God of all weariness, God of our silent eternity,
thou who hast brought us the
Pantry is the perfect solution for your soul food cravings. Indulge in some of your favorite comfort foods like catfish, shrimp and grits, wings, and brisket, just to name a few. But wait, of course you can't forget dessert. Annie Mae's has an assortment of delectable cakes made fresh to order. You can enjoy this delicious menu at 1700 Northside Drive, Suite A7. Come down and enjoy Annie Mae's handcrafted dishes made with pride for your pleasure. Life happens, and when it does, the law firm of Althea DeBar Johnson, PC, and Tamara Wood is the law firm people turn to for planning and managing their legal affairs and protecting their current and future assets. The firm specializes in wealth protection through legal services that include estate planning, probate administration, and guardianship. This law firm promises to be truthful and honest, provide personalized attention, and they are focused on results that best suit your needs. For a consultation, contact them today at 404-584-5555 or visit them on the web at adjpclaw.com. The law firm of Althea DeBar Johnson, PC, and Tamara Wood, helping you plan for today and for the future so you can get on with the business of living.
All right, y'all. Welcome back to the old school, new school, old fashioned health show. Good health inside and out here on the Real 1100.
Man, what's going on, Alvin? What's going on, everybody in the world? What's going on?
You said we got a caller, man.
Oh yeah, we got a caller.
Who we got on the phone? Who we got on the line?
You know the one and only.
Uh-oh, Mr. Carl Callender. Who we got?
Yeah. Excuse me. Y'all making me laugh. Hi.
How are you?
I'm doing well. How y'all doing?
Oh, we're doing great. Thank you so much for calling in. We've been waiting on this call.
Well, you said 4:15.
That's no problem. No problem. You know, we're trying to keep this voter thing going.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, absolutely. And I appreciate y'all having me on just to talk briefly about it.
Before you talk about that, I do have a question. Tell me what you
think. Yes, sir.
You went to an historically black college, right?
I certainly did, too.
Okay, so we're listening to attorney at Theodore Barr Johnson, the one and only. So, you know, we always play the Black National Anthem every time we have our show, right?
That's correct.
So we're trying to figure out, why is it that historically black colleges, if no one else, why don't they play the Black National Anthem at the HBCU? What would you think would be the reason?
We still don't have a firm connection to our past. And I think that sometimes we are now not as proud of our past as we should be. And I think also because we don't know our rich history. And it started before we came to the shores of the United States or America. Mm-hmm. It was from the beginning. We are the original people.
Mm. You know, I think Tony, that a lot of times we don't realize our power of what we're capable of doing because we don't understand our history. What do you think?
I think so. That's why we don't sing the Black National Anthem, because we are ashamed.
Or even know.
Or know it. Yeah, you're right.
Because we're not put on information about it. We don't have that much information or just about who made what, you know.
Right.
Just about with all the inventions. I think about all the inventions that we made. And, you know, I know a lot of people don't know about the elevators, the toilets, the just right. everything, you know. So it's crazy.
Well, we just wanted to get your opinion on it. We always ask the question, and I attended an HBCU, and I've asked my own alumni, it's like, why we don't play the Black National Anthem?
Right.
However, we will get mad and kneel for the flag with the NFL.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Well, I'm protesting the NFL for now, yes.
And now you've not been watching no games?
Oh, no.
You know, I'm have to be honest, I hadn't watched one either.
I don't do that.
And I would have to say a lot of this was brought to the light after, for two reasons, because of the current administration.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
And then because of the what's been shown with a lot of NFL players getting away with certain things, like the way they treat women, and it's like they just get a little slap on the hand, and then that's it.
Right.
So, yeah. Yeah. All right, so now that we got that out of the way,
you feel a little bit better now.
I feel a little bit better. Here's the thing: we know with voting, we can make some changes. We know
voting
gives us the power of change. So, talk to us about the voting. We know we've already passed the deadline to register, right?
Mm-hmm.
We have passed the deadline to register, but guess what? We have early voting starting Monday,
and that's the whole concept.
Really?
Yep. Yeah.
Yes, we can early vote or advance voting, which is what they call it, starting Monday. And that will be all the way up until November, I think the 2nd is the cutoff date for advance voting. So you can go to your whatever county you are located. There will be several voting locations. You can go now, start Monday, and usually the hours, they may run like from 7 in the morning to 7 in the afternoon, Monday through Friday. They will have some weekend voting. Some of the counties will have weekend, Saturday and Sunday voting. So we need to take advantage of that and early vote.
Okay.
Vote now.
So I guess if someone finds that there's a problem, the only problem they can fix right now is if they had the wrong polling voting location. Otherwise, if they've been kicked out of the system, it's too late for them to do anything about that, isn't it?
It may be too late to do anything about the system, but with advance or early voting, you don't have to worry about whether or not you're at the correct precinct.
Mm.
So, for instance, DeKalb County may have like 7 or 8 precincts or voting locations open during the advanced voting. So you can go to any one of those locations and vote. You can go to those. So DeKalb has about 7 or 8. So you just find out, you just go to the DeKalb County voter registration office, and there you can get your sample ballot again, and you can get a early voting site and time listing, and you just go to one of those.
I think I'm gonna vote Monday. I'm not gonna even.
I'm going to vote. I mean, and it's better because I feel like you can avoid all those long lines and everything as well, because a lot of people, you know, usually make up excuses. Oh, I got to go to work. I don't got time. So when you have that early voting ready to go, you can just be in and out. Right. I mean, why not take advantage, right?
Right. You can be in and you can be out.
Mm-hmm.
And you don't have to worry about whether you are at the right precinct or voting location.
Right.
Now, again, I guess one of the hot topics, if you've been paying attention, is that Brian Kemp, who is currently serving as the Secretary of State here in Georgia,
mm-hmm.
but also running as the governor,
mm-hmm.
has placed on hold 53,000 voter registration applications.
I saw that.
So that's mm-hmm. about 70%, or 70% of them are African American.
Hmm.
And so how will that, so how can he legally do that? What can be done, or what's it all about?
Well, to me, there's several issues that's going on. He can legally do that because the state legislature here in Georgia passed this law saying that if there's similar names, or if there's a misspelling or a missing hyphen in your name, because I'm DeBar Johnson, so if I fill out my application and my name is not exactly the way it looks on my driver's license, or mm-hmm. I transpose it some numbers, then they can not register me to vote. And that's what has happened. And it has affected, again, 70% of African Americans. But the Lawyers Committee for Civil Rights under law has filed a lawsuit against Brian Kemp and the Secretary of State office to try to do something about this.
So, you know, so this, now this brings me to the Supreme Court situation. So if it gets to the point where it goes all the way to the Supreme Court, that's where the president has picked his own hand-picked people, and it would just go to the Supreme Court and could possibly not get anywhere. Is that possible?
That's possible, but I don't think this is going to go that far.
Okay.
It's just that it's just another challenge, another, you know, issue that has to be contend with. What I would suggest to folks is that, again, go and you vote early. If there's a problem, then you probably can get a provisional ballot and try to straighten the issue out by going to the main voter registration office in the county that you're located to resolve the issue. And you have time to do it.
Right, because we're voting early.
Yes, because you're voting early. You're not waiting to November 6th.
So these votes that he's put on hold, and 70% of them being African American, really just pisses me off for one. But what if it's possible? Is it possible that if I go and I try to go vote, and I'm one of those people that he's put on hold because he's trying to say my name wasn't not like my driver's license?
Mm-hmm.
Can I file a lawsuit against him? Because I think if you got 70,000 people filing a lawsuit, that should really make things change.
I know, right? You would think so.
I think it's strength in numbers. I think with the Lawyers Committee for the Civil Rights under law, and there's some other organizations that have joined in with this lawsuit to try to resolve this issue. But that's not the only issue with Brian Kemp. You know that he has also deleted over almost over 1 million people from the voter registration rolls, because some of them legitimate, but my understanding that a lot of them aren't, because if you haven't voted in the last 2 or 3 election cycles, then you're automatically off. And there's some other issues that have occurred. So you may not be registered to vote. Like I don't know if I stated this the last time, I went and checked maybe a couple of days before we had to register to vote, and then found out that my name wasn't on the record. I wasn't on the record when I went to the Secretary of State's office.
Wow.
Of course, you know, I pitched the fit. I went down to DeKalb County to the main voter registration office and asked them what was going on, and they showed that I was actually registered. So there's going to be a lot of problems.
I hate this so bad. It just...
And here's the ironic thing. You got... It's almost like the fox watching the hen house. He's the Secretary of State. He's in charge of the election. He's running for the top office, and he's overseeing everything.
Right.
Wow.
And guess what? It is perfectly legal. It is not against the law for him to still hold the position as Secretary of State.
Of course not.
And run for the office of governor and oversee the election.
Mm-hmm.
And that law needs to change.
Mm-hmm.
I pray to God that when our new governor, Stacey Abrams, yes, gets in office,
oh yeah,
that she makes that change.
Yeah, at least propose that legislation.
Right, right.
Yeah.
So what else can you tell us that you're passionate about as far as making sure that they vote? I mean, we've said it like a million times. Please go vote early. Please vote early.
Right.
And I guess we could just—that's all we can say—is try to convince people to vote early. Or go, yes, maybe get your neighbor that may not be, mm-hmm, able to go to the polls. Or
that's
take a friend,
right,
with,
right,
you.
And we have to encourage everybody to go out and vote. And we got to also understand, because one of the things they were saying about the young people, it's going to be imperative that young people go out and vote. They may feel that they don't have anything to vote for, but it's not true.
Right.
Because the legislation that's coming down the pike that affects student loans, that affects the HBCUs, that just affect housing, your Social Security. If you get Social Security disability or benefits, they're trying to change that and take that away. So if you as a young person getting Social Security, what do you think is going to happen if the wrong folks get into office? Or if mama and daddy and them getting Social Security and is taken away, who you think going to have to take up the slack?
That's right.
Are you serious?
And it's like they put the least of,
yes,
the further out on in the street.
Yeah.
Yes. You know, it affects our health care. It affects our environment.
Man.
So
that's
it all
scary.
Affects us all.
That is scary.
I wonder, yeah, do people really realize how serious this is?
Mm.
Apparently not.
But it is very serious. And then when you don't vote, you're still voting.
That's right. When you,
yeah,
don't vote, you're still,
yep,
voting.
it's just,
yeah,
like when I tell people, if you think you, just because you don't have a will, that doesn't mean that you don't have a will. You do have a will. Your things are going to go. Your assets are going to the very people you probably don't want them to go.
Exactly.
So the state of Georgia has a will for you.
Exactly.
And so that goes all to Brian Kemp.
Yeah.
Mm.
Could possibly go to Brian Kemp, yeah. Or go to the state of Georgia, I'm sorry.
Right.
Yeah.
Go to the state of Georgia. Well, I mean, and under his control, though.
Right.
For now.
Yeah.
So we just can't let you talk about the voters thing. We need them to know who you are and exactly what you do and how to reach you.
I'm your probate and estate planning attorney. That's who I am.
I like that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, already.
Actually, this is who I am.
Yeah, already.
And, of course, you know, I do wills. We do trust here.
Right.
So we help people with the administration of estates, guardianships, and conservatorships. So that's what we do.
Mm.
You know the difference between the type of law that Athea practices and regular corporate or other kind of laws. Not that one is looked down on the other,
mm-hmm,
but to me, your type of practice is really, really community related.
Right.
Is making a difference in the community and the livelihood of people. It's not the exact same thing as having a corporate attorney or somebody to do stuff like that, but you handle the matters at heart.
Yeah. That really changes a lot of things,
yeah,
you know.
You
that exactly. Like if you don't do it, then it's like you're really heading down a road of destruction. But the fact of the matter is, you have access to all these type of information and actually can do it.
Yeah.
Have and you know,
when you need
exactly.
One, trust when you need
exactly.
One. We really appreciate
yes,
what you do.
Yes.
No problem.
Really appreciate what you
no
do.
No problem. Thank you for having me.
We look forward to speaking with you again next week, same time, same station.
Oh, yeah.
Absolutely. Y'all have a wonderful weekend.
You
all
too,
right,
thanks.
You
have
too.
Have a great one.
All right. Bye-bye.
Now, did y'all hear that, people?
Man.
Did you hear that?
I love that sister.
I know, right?
I love her.
this whole voting thing.
Yeah.
And to know that Brian Kemp can just press a button, get rid of things, delete stuff.
Yeah.
Nothing
that could really affect your life. So when you look at, let's keep it real. When you look at certain people and be like, you know, how did he get that way? Where did, you don't know people's stories. So by you not voting and having other people go in this office, say for instance, and it's going to happen, let's keep it real. Your folks are going to pass one of these days.
Right.
And if you don't move the certain right way, if you don't vote for the right reasons and all this type of stuff, that Social Security that you're supposed to get may not come to you. And that means you out here on your own and pushing on your own. So when you look at the other man to be like, how he got to where he is, just think about those type of things that is put into effect for that person to be like that. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So again, just by you not voting, you were voting already and could lead to a path of destruction for just not you, for everybody.
Everybody in your family.
So just keep that in mind. Vote, people.
And you should, even if, just talk to Brian Kemp people for just a second.
Right.
Do you really want somebody to run your state that had to cheat to get to,
man,
to get your vote?
Come on now.
Just think.
That should tell you something.
If he does that to hurt you.
Yeah.
To hurt people, his opponent.
Yeah.
And just because you voted for him, you don't think something to come around that he won't hurt you too?
Exactly.
It's all about the power and not about the people.
Yep.
So any of Brian Kemp people thinking about voting for him because you think he's the right man for the job, but if you got to get the job by taking it or by lying or by stealing or getting rid of votes, you can't have my vote because that means you going to wait your turn to get me too.
Mm-hmm. And that's scary because now, before you even get elected or whatever case may be, you thinking about self already.
Already. Not about the people.
Not about the people, about self already. So even if you, even though you're not, but even if you get the title, you know what I'm saying, you're still thinking of self.
And
this, again, leading to a path of destruction. Because when you think about self and not think about others, that's when everything goes crazy. Because believe it or not, people, everybody with their everyday job, ticking, talking, that's what makes the world go around.
So here's what I know one thing for
you
sure.
You did?
One thing I definitely know for sure.
What's up?
Karma is really not good.
Man.
And God don't like
that. Man, so, it's real.
If I was you, I'd think twice about this because you may do this to the people.
Yeah.
But your time is coming.
Hey, man, everybody got a contract, believe it or not.
Got a contract.
Everybody got a contract, you know what I'm saying? And it's crazy because I was listening to this interview today, by the brother Mike Epps, and he pointed something out that just really
resonated.
Got to me, of just about how every day we are stacking up meaningless money and, you know, fighting for power and all these types of things. So what I'm saying is, it's just like you're really being greedy. You're really leading everybody to a path of destruction for money that you're stacking up and eventually going to give to other people.
Right.
Something that you can't even take with you, you know, at the end of the road. So all I'm saying is, at the end of the day, man, we gotta think about each other and we gotta vote and do all the right things for all the right reasons.
All the right reasons. Because when you try to hurt me, you're hurting yourself.
Man.
You just don't know it yet.
Man.
All right, on this sermon, we're gonna take us a quick break here. You're listening to Old School, New School on the Old Fashioned Health Show on the Real 1100.
Yeah. little thing I do, you're on my mind, you're on my mind. You, every little thing I do, you're on my mind, you're on my mind. You, every little thing I do, you're on my mind, you're on my mind. Hey.
Life happens, and when it does, the law firm of Althea DeBar Johnson, PC, and Tamara Wood is the law firm people turn to for planning and managing their legal affairs and protecting their current and future assets. The firm specializes in wealth protection through legal services that include estate planning, probate administration, and guardianship. This law firm promises to be truthful and honest, provide personalized attention, and they are focused on results that best suit your needs. For a consultation, contact them today at 404-584-5555 or visit them on the web at adjpclaw.com. The law firm of Althea DeBar Johnson, PC, and Tamara Wood, helping you plan for today and for the future so you can get on with the business of living.
The sinister cries haunted Mary through the night. Dawn neared, and still the voice tormented her. She ran towards the safety of her car, flung open the door, and a coyote had somehow gotten locked inside. But the damaged interior was covered, thanks to Farmers Insurance. Coyote Carpool, August 1st, 2015. Talk to a Farmers agent. We know a thing or two because we've seen a thing or two.
We are Farmers. Bum, 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 bum.
Call Todd Tettleton at the Tettleton Agency for Farmers Insurance at 404-327-6377.
All right, y'all. Welcome back to the Old School, New School, Old Fashioned Health Show here on The Real 1100.
What's going on, Alvin? What's going on, Atlanta? How y'all doing?
So we were just talking at the break about Mr. Brian Kemp being able to delete names. I'm wondering, can they add? If you can delete, you can add.
No, right? You definitely can. You definitely can. But it's just not... I don't necessarily think, you know, you have to kill somebody to be a criminal. You know what I'm saying? Or just a crook in general. You know what I'm saying?
Criminals and crooks come. Let me put it to you like this. Now, check this out. Are you ready for this?
Yes, sir.
Criminals and crooks come in all different
shapes and sizes.
And colors.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So, and that's,
all that.
That's
and I believe that you're robbing the people that you're deleted. You know what I'm saying? Those are people voices. You know what I'm saying? Those are people that's trying to have something different, and by you taking that away, aren't you stealing my rights?
Yeah, of course.
Okay, then. So I think that's
some people are able to do things without a conscious, old school.
Okay.
They can do things without a conscious and not realize
or repercussions,
especially if you're controlling the repercussions.
Yes, exactly. So yes. I mean, just acknowledge that, man. Just know that, you know, you have sleazy people that's trying to do sleazy things, but I just want you to know how important it is to vote, so you know you can chase those certain types of things. But even when you have a person that, you know, is in a position of power taking your vote, doesn't mean you don't vote at all. You know what I'm saying? Because you still got to go to bed at night just with the thought in your head, like, look, I made my move, and what happens. You know what I'm saying? So let's keep it real.
So get this, the FDA has expanded the investigation of illegal cigarette marketing to kids.
Mm,
so they people are illegally marketing cigarette use to kids. The U.S. Food and Drug Administration, they went on with their investigation of the e-cigarette companies. They did this on Friday, sending a letter to 21 companies in an effort to uncover whether they are marketing illegally outside the agency's compliances for policy. So, like the e-cigarette thing, that whole thing, you smoke the e-cigarette, that e-cigarette is just as dangerous as smoking regular tobacco.
I know.
Yeah.
I know.
And they
extended it for the kids? What? Yeah. What?
So there's an investigation that's going on right now. The FDA launched an investigation where companies are actually marketing the e-cigarette companies, the e-cigarette toward kids.
Oh, man.
Because kids are one of the bigger components of this whole thing.
Exactly.
Well, they think that looks cool. And there's a lot of different side effects for the e-cigarettes.
I feature. All because of a dollar. You want to just, you know, promote this to our youngins. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's sad, man.
The federal law prohibits the sale of e-cigarettes to people under the age of 18.
Yep.
But more than 2 million middle and high school students were current users of e-cigarettes in 2017.
I believe it.
I'm going to tell you something. It'd be interesting to look at the demographics of the culture of people that don't eat cigarettes. I can tell you now from what I can tell.
What's up?
They don't look like minorities.
Yeah.
They don't look like minorities smoking the e-cigarette.
Yeah, I know. I know. I mean, I know. We get the real thing.
Yeah. We're going to need a pair of Filter King Cools.
Right. Right.
Which is bad for you, nevertheless, but just to let you know. When you hurt one, you hurt all. So when you remove these regulations to allow big companies to do these things, you think you giving them the opportunity to make money. You think you're raising the stock market to get more money. But then you don't realize you're hurting your own kids every day. And they look like you.
Yep. And it just it all trickles down, man. Everything has a consequence. And when you think about the dollar and not think about what's happening, the real big picture, you tend to lose focus of what it really is. And it's going to affect the future. It's affecting our kids, man.
Yep.
The
love of money.
Yeah.
The love of money is dangerous.
That's a sacrifice these companies, these tobacco companies, willing to take, man. So, hey, like I said, if you want the change, you can make the change. You just got to figure out the way to do it, man, and just get out here and vote and just make all the right decisions.
So, in the news also, nearly 800 dietary supplements contain unapproved drug ingredients, according to a study. So, you know, to get the supplements, they ain't supposed to have drugs in them. That's not true.
Yeah, I bet.
It says nearly 800 dietary supplements sold over the counter from 2007 to 2016 contain an unapproved drug ingredients, according to a new analysis that was done with the administration. So, you get these type of supplements and you think you're getting like a B supplement or a E supplement. Yeah, they got some chemicals in them. So it says the presence of prescription medicine often at the unknown concentration means the supplement, using supplements, they think it doesn't have any drugs in them. But some of them are harmful to health and those who take them, according to a study. So.
I really feel like, man, we just putting stuff money into stuff, man. I just feel like we doing a lot of stuff behind closed doors and just promoting poison and literally killing us, man.
So, like, you know, I told you last week, remember they were saying that the vitamin D supplements. Yeah,
right.
Told people to stop.
Yeah.
The Food and Drug Administration says stop taking the supplements, vitamin D, because it doesn't do anything for strong bones and things. But that's how they was marketing for a long time.
For as long as I can remember.
And now it does not do anything they said it was going to do.
They even had a drink or something. I forgot. But it had vitamin D.
Yeah.
You know, like some kids drink or whatever. Vitamin
and they
D.
They always push it off on the kids.
Exactly.
And they make it look candyish like.
Exactly.
Colorful like. Yep. And you get your kid to take this vitamin supplement D.
Now.
In
2018.
In 2018. When all you got to do is get in the sun for about 30 minutes and you straight.
And you good.
But the kids don't play anymore because they're doing technology.
Technology, game, all games, this online.
And the sun is no, you know what else? Old school.
What's up?
I don't ever remember going to school with anybody that wore a long trench coat in the summertime.
A long trench coat.
You know how
coat.
They be wearing the long coats and stuff? We the kids, we were dressing them all with the black.
Yeah, like, I mean, I'm from Florida,
Matrix
so.
Matrix type thing.
Yeah, yeah, okay, I see what you're talking about. Matrix. I never seen one. I never.
Yeah, I don't know what's going on with the kids who's doing
I that. I never, thing, but I don't think they should be allowed. What you got in that trench coat? Let's keep it 100. A lot of things been happening.
It sure is.
A lot of things been happening. So you want to have because every kid when they start school or whenever they have to sign a book of a student code. I forgot what it's called, but a dress code. Yes, dress code, what you need, what you can and cannot bring, all that stuff. So a dress code to have a trench coat or whatever case may be needs to, unless it's like snowing and you like waist deep in it, then I can understand. But when it comes down to Destiny schools and all the stuff like that, yeah, no kid should be having a trench coat on. What you hiding?
Wow.
So let's keep 100, man. It's been real lately.
So one more thing about the supplement.
What's
they
up?
Said most of the adulterated products, about 45% were marketed for sexual enhancements, those supplements. The other one was 41% was for muscle building and weight loss, and 12% drugs were found for sexual enhanced products, including fentanyl and all those different kind of names that and they use a lot of supplements for erectile dysfunction. And
right.
I tell y'all, if you change your diet, I promise you, if you change your diet, you will see a lot of the things that go on in your body. The body is a well-oiled machine. It
right.
heals itself. It does what it needs to
right.
do. And you will be surprised at what you can accomplish mm-hmm. without taking all these different supplements, mm-hmm. without taking all these different medications.
Right.
And as you can see, supplements seem now to have medicine in them all mm-hmm. of a sudden. Chemicals, like this is a supplement that don't have chemicals. Well, that's not true. They do.
Yeah. Right? Yeah. Yeah.
We trying to tell y'all the truth out here. Trying to tell you about voting. Trying to tell you about what you're putting in your system.
Trying to get you right.
Trying to get you right. You are listening to Old School, New School on the Old Fashioned Health Show on the Real 1100.
Yes, sir. Yeah, man, try to get you up. Yeah,
I was singing.
You know,
I had all those notes. You heard that in here.
Yeah.
This is Alvin and Jerry, Old School and New School on the Old Fashioned Health Show. Good health inside and out.
Oh, yeah.
It is Friday. It's Friday, Jerry. Mm-hmm. I'm so glad. Man, I still got work to do.
It's always work to do, man. Because it's the weekend doesn't mean you stop working.
Living for the weekend.
Yes.
You got to play some of that. I think we're going to find. You got to find that, too.
What you say?
Living for the weekend.
Living for the weekend.
Yeah, we got to find.
By who?
Hey, man, living for the weekend.
Look at you.
Yeah, yeah. I forgot it was. But anyway, so let me tell you about a recall. There's this spray called Sprayology. It's a homeopathic based medicine that has possible contaminations in it. Sprayology is what it's called. For those of you all that may be familiar with that, there's a recall on it, so for possible contamination. So you might want to take that back. I told you all yesterday about the pistachios. Please remember that. It's the weekend. You might want to get a big bowl of pistachios.
Oh, yeah.
Watch a little game. Don't do it. Not this brand. The brand that has the recall is Bazin's, B-A-Z-Z-I-N, apostrophe S. Mm. So you don't want to get any of those pistachios. They have a salmonella poisoning is what the recall for that. And for my...
Man, that stuff's spreading too, know, man. Right? Like crazy.
The Country Ham Rolls. Hysteria is what's in those. Their brand is made by Lady Fingers. I told you all about this yesterday, but just want to make sure you all know, because I don't want nobody, you know, getting some of this stuff in their system and you kind of missed out on, all right? My ice cream lovers, Sweet Me Creamery.
Oh, Lord.
Don't do it. Has undeclared peanut in them, and so those of you that have peanut allergies, don't do it, then your throat gonna close up and you ain't gonna be able to talk, you ain't gonna be able to swallow, you gonna be in trouble, right?
Man.
This is Alvin and Jerry. Jerry gonna play us, and let me tell you, we're gonna hit it and quit. We're gonna see what kind of skill musically he got.
We're gonna
check some of your music skills.
You're putting me up.
His last few minutes of musical skills look like. there's an organic plant protein shake also that has an undeclared almond. It's called Forage, F-O-R-A-G-E-R, Forager. It's an organic plant protein shake. See, organic, although it has the name organic and plant protein shake, which means it's manufactured.
Right.
Let you know it didn't come from the plant itself.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So all this extra stuff.
Anything to promote, anything to sell, right?
If you're allergic to almonds, don't do it.
Yeah.
Don't do it. All right. Here we go. See what Jerry got.
Yeah, all right.
Come on.
Friend told me to ask you, is that for a reason?
Why it always got to be for a reason? It can't be like some good fun, feel good music.
Okay, we'll call it feel good. Hey, this is Alvin and Jerry, old school, new school, here on the Old Fashioned Health Show. Listen, I want you all please to remember attorney at Theodore Bar Johnson was on with us today, emphasizing it over and over.
Word.
So please trying to get you all to get out and vote.
Mm-hmm.
And keep in mind, your vote must count if they have to delete your votes or keep you from voting. Your vote matters. It matters.
Right.
If it didn't, they wouldn't delete them.
Right.
If it didn't, they wouldn't try to put a barrier to keep you from voting.
You ain't lying.
Which means your vote is valuable.
Valuable and especially to the majority of the main population.
That's right.
You know, the main community. That's why 75, you know, 73, 75.
70% of the minority
70%
have been accidentally deleted by Secretary of State Brian Kemp.
So you powerful than you think.
I don't even know how he did it, because first of all, you got people that work for you. Did you give them this order to do that?
Right.
You gave them the order and they accidentally, there's too many steps to do this to keep you from making this mistake. You know what I'm saying?
You ain't lying.
Yeah, so you didn't just walk by the button and then made a mistake and click. And get this. Just so odd. So they got 70% of them black minority votes, right? Minority black, Hispanic.
Right.
So that means there's a button that says Hispanic. There's a button that says okay. You know, it got, there's a button that says females.
Look,
it got to be enough to know, right?
I wouldn't be surprised if it really was, yeah, man. I wouldn't even be surprised.
Blacks only washroom, yeah, that kind of thing.
Yeah. Come on, man. It's no different. Just it's the same thing, but just a different game. That's all it is.
I'm telling y'all. God don't like ugly. Hey, man. Please stop it. Stop it. You see things are not. We having a lot of natural disasters and stuff right now. You notice that?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's bad, y'all. Yeah. You all have been listening to Old School, New School every Thursday and Friday here.
Oh, yeah.
On the Old Fashioned Health Show on the Real 1100. We ask y'all, please be safe. Be careful. To my people out there, your job is to get home safe.
Right.
You get pulled over by the police, all you want to do is get home.
Yep.
You just want to get home.
Exactly.
No sudden moves, no combing your hair, brushing your hair, you're putting on glass. Just stay still.
Exactly, get home safe, man. Right? But we going to be all right, man.
Yeah, we are. Y'all have a good one.
And I know he's mine.
Thanks for stopping by Old Fashioned Health with your host, Alvin. We hope this show has been informative and entertaining. And more importantly, we hope that we led you in the right direction to have good health inside and out. For more information on Old Fashioned Health, please visit our website at oldfashionedhealth.com. And be sure to join Alvin Monday through Friday from 4 to 5 p.m. for Old Fashioned Health right here on 1100 a.m. Take care.